The Anoka-Hennepin School Board voted this week to go to voters this fall with three levy questions. The first two would renew levies that are set to expire. The third question would raise new money to address growing mental health concerns.
We will move on to our levy discussion and decisions.
The school board took up the levy discussion at its regularly scheduled meeting on Monday night. It's something they've been discussing for the past year. Question one would renew the $34.5 million operating levy last renewed by voters in 2012. Funding is used to maintain programs and services, along with keeping class sizes down. As an existing levy, there would be no tax increase. Question two renews a $4.5 million capital levy for technology, first approved by voters back in 2011. Again, as it's an existing levy, there would be no tax increase. Question three would involve a tax increase of about $10 a month for 10 years for a $250,000 home. The operating levy would be used to extend mental health and social-emotional support for students, including academic support for underachieving students.
You know, question one for me, if it weren't to pass, that's a dismantling of our school district. That would be brutal. And like Board Member Simon said, it's not about scaring the public. It's not about anything other than look at the reality. Take 10% of your family's operating income and make it go away and try to make it through a couple months. Not going to happen.
To me, this is about giving people a choice. And so I will support all three going forward. I have heard over and over and over again that we need to give support to students for social emotional learning and to help them bridge this gap that we've had in this past year. And $10 a month is a great start at a way to do that that is desperately needed.
District 11 residents will cast their votes on the three questions on Tuesday, November 2nd. A recent survey conducted on behalf of the school district showed more than 80% support for renewing the current levies and more than 60% support for question three.